Hi, I'm Kaylee, and today I'm going to tell you about series where every single book in the series, every single book in the entire series, got 5 stars from me. In case you didn't know, Books for MKs is a charity that donates books to missionary kids. If you want to donate to the kids, you can do so at GoFundMe.com. There's a link down in the description and a button at the end of this video where you can donate to the kids. So it's pretty rare for anyone to find a series where you read the entire series. Maybe it's a trilogy, maybe it's a duology, maybe there's 7 books in the series, maybe there's 20 books in the series, and every single one of them is a 5-star book. I mean, especially in trilogies, there's always that middle book syndrome where the middle book is just kind of meh. It just doesn't have the same kind of energy that the first or the last book might. So I just had the idea to go through and look through all my star ratings on Goodreads and find out, are there any series where I gave every single book 5 stars? Like, there was no middle book syndrome here. Every single word that this author wrote was golden. And let me tell you, I have a list, people. I have a list. You guys know I love making lists. So I actually have several series that are all 5 stars. And then I kind of have like my honorable mentions where all the books in the series got 4 or 5 stars. So still like, wow, that's way up there. And then I have series where every book so far has gotten 4 or 5 stars, but I haven't finished reading the series yet. So I can't really say that every book in the series got 5 stars because I haven't finished it, but it's going pretty good so far. So I'm gonna put it in the honorable mentions. So we're gonna start with, these are the series that every single book got 5 stars all the time, every day, every book. So within this list, these aren't really in any order. They're just kind of in the order that they popped up on my Goodreads as I was looking for all of these. So first we have The Enchanted Forest Chronicles, every single book, 5 stars, wonderful. The Mysterious Benedict Society, one of my very favorites. The Charlie Bone series, and there are a lot of books in this series, so it is saying something that every single one was 5 stars. What in the world? Then I actually have a manga, Your Lie in April. And this really got 5 stars because it's all about a pianist. And I'm a pianist, and I'm all about musicians. And I just found it to be so compelling, like right in there inside the musician mind. It was just so beautiful. Next, of course, are some of my favorite series of all time, The Chronicles of Narnia. Obviously, every single one gets 5 stars because I am a crazy Narnia fan. And obviously, Lord of the Rings had to be on this list, of course, along with The Hobbit, because I am a crazy Lord of the Rings fan. And then we have several series by Lucy Maud Montgomery, one of my very favorite authors. The Anna Green Gables series, all get 5 stars. The Emily of New Moon trilogy, one of my favorites all the time. And the Story Girl duology, which is just completely adorable. The Farseer trilogy by Robin Hobb, all got 5 stars from me. Although I have to say I've read some other Robin Hobb that I really did not like, but this one I did like. And there is a duology by L.M. Alcott, the 8 Cousins duology, and both of those get 5 stars, and I have read and reread and reread them since I was a teenager, and I never get tired of them. Also, the Damar Chronicles, The Blue Sword and Here in the Crown by Robin McKinley, both of those get 5 stars. The Marilyn the Magician duology by Patricia C. Reed, always magical. And next we're gonna go into series that all got 4 and 5 stars. So some of the books were 4 stars, some of the books were 5 stars, but most of them were probably 5 stars, and then there was like one that was a 4-star. So I already know what you're thinking. You're already thinking, Kaylee, what is going on with this list? Where is the most important book series of all time, Harry Potter? Where is Harry Potter on this list? And I'm sorry to say that one or two of the Harry Potter books only got 4 stars from me. Chamber of Secrets is my least favorite of the Harry Potter series, and it only got 4 stars. Most of the Harry Potter books are 5 stars, but that puts it in the honorable mentions. I still love Harry Potter, though. I just don't like Training Bureau of Secrets. I'm sorry. The New Policeman trilogy, which is full of Irish magic. The Pendragon series, which is full of time travel and magic. The Lunar Chronicles, obviously, had to be on this list. The Swallows and Amazon series, which is all about sailing and camping and treasure hunting. Sherlock Holmes, of course, everybody loves Sherlock. The Wildwood trilogy, which is absolutely wonderful. Sorcery and Cecilia, which is like Victorian times with magic. So you have, you know, enchanted chocolate pots and things. Now, I will say, I am a big Percy Jackson fan. However, Percy Jackson and the Olympians, there was one book in there that got 3 stars, so that doesn't actually make this list. But Heroes of Olympus all got 4 and 5 stars, so Rick Riordan still makes the list. And you have to admit, the first Percy Jackson books are kind of juvenile, and then once we get to Heroes of Olympus, it's much more mature, and the plots are a lot more complex. You know, there's just a lot more going on there that's more enjoyable, and so of course it gets more stars. The wonderful classic Darkest Rising series, which is so full of myth and mystical creatures. The absolutely wonderful, hilarious Howl's Moving Castle series. The Keys to the Kingdom, which starts with Mr. Monday. This series always surprised me. Every single book was so imaginative. The beautifully enigmatic Enola Holmes, which is Sherlock Holmes' little sister, so you know I loved it. The Princess Academy trilogy, which just has such a good magical world building. It's just so rich in all like the history and stuff. I love it. The Miss Mantle Chronicles, all about a little squirrel with a big destiny. The Door Within, where a boy travels to another land and becomes a knight. And of course, the Giver Quartet. So deep and meaningful and complex and beautiful. Next come the series that have all gotten 4 and 5 stars, but I haven't finished the series yet, so I still have a few books to go. The Scarlet Pimpernel, I've read most of these, but I think I have 3 or 4 left, so let's hope that those last ones are just as good as the first ones. The Penderwicks, which are still being written. So every single Penderwick book, I think, has gotten 5 stars, but I'm just waiting on the rest of them to be written. The Wizard of Earthsea, which originally was a trilogy and then it turned into a quintet, and now I'm just like, how many books are in this series? I can't even tell anymore. So I've read the original trilogy, and I have not read, like, the extra Earthsea books yet. The Young Wizard series, which starts with So You Want to Be a Wizard by Diane Duane. Every single one of these books has blown me away. Every book so far has gotten 5 stars. It's imaginative, it's magical, it's just heart-wrenching. Oh, so good. The Cute Old-Fashioned Borrowers by Mary Norton. Somehow, when I was reading through The Borrowers, I skipped one. And I need to go back and read that last one, but I'm sure it's just as delightful as the others. The epic fantasy series, The Books of Pelennor, which is all about this girl who discovers that she has magic hidden within. The Kingkiller Chronicles, which all of us are still waiting 20 years later, waiting for the last book to be published. Looking at you, Patrick Rothfuss. And the wonderful Chasing Vermeer series, which is all about these kids who solve like these art puzzles and, you know, solve like these architectural mysteries. So it's all about puzzles. So of course I love it. And finally, the classic What Katie Did series, which is about just this lovely family, you know, growing up at the turn of the century. And it's just so old fashioned and charming and sweet. Okay, that is all of them. Those are series with all 5 stars or all 4 and 5 stars. Oh my goodness, all the books that I love that are near and dear to my heart. So leave me a comment down below and let me know what are some series that you've read where every single book was just like written in gold. Give me some recommendations down in the comments because I love reading series. And I love reading series. I mean, in case you couldn't tell from this long video and my long list, I kind of love reading series. Yes, I do. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe. And remember, the right book in the right hands at the right time can change the world.